God promises to betray you in the Bible? The Bible says God shall make it rain on the just and the unjust. Want to hear some biblical examples of who God betrayed in the Bible? First of all, my name is Bob Hickman, and God entered into my body like a body my same size. Like me floating into you or you floating into me, I see nonstop visions from God. I am the world's only Holy Ghost-filled man. Anyway, let's go back to the Bible. God called Job perfect. But perfect Job said, "The arrows of the Almighty are against me." At first, thieves came and stole all that Job had. Job laid out in his front yard and fasted for 7 days. All of Israel saw this. God appeared to Job and told him he repented of the evil that he thought had done toward him. The second thing that happened to Job after that was God sent a storm. The Bible says God sent the storm. And the storm killed most of Job's family. Right back out to the front yard Job goes. And Job fasted 7 days. And God appeared and said, "I repent of the evil I thought of doing toward you." That ain't thinking of doing it toward, that's actually doing it. The very last thing was God put boils all over Job's body. Can you imagine that? Job went right back out to the front yard. And anyway, God appeared and repented. He said, "I repent of the evil that I thought of doing toward you." But Job added a few things. See, in the Bible, Job said, "The arrows of the Almighty are against me." Now, why would God come against his perfect servant? But here's what Job said to God when God appeared. Job said, "Thou terrifiest me in dreams." Is that where Freddy Krueger came from? And Job also said, "Thou fillest my face full of wrinkles." That means God was ripping his face. Now, let's go to Ezekiel. Ezekiel said, "And the Spirit entered into me," like it says in my van. The very next event that happened was God appeared and said, "I'm going to send your wife a stroke." She died that night. Isaac, the Bible, God said in the Bible he was pleased with Isaac. But the angel of the Lord appeared to Isaac and said that he was going to fight against him all night. The angel of the Lord is God. Anyway, Isaac prevailed. They fought all night. You might say, how can somebody fight God? Well, God was inside the bodies of the Old Testament prophets. The Bible says, "And the Holy Spirit which was in them," Spirit is God. You might say, how would a God that is inside the body of his servants fight against his servants? Well, I told you what he did to Job. Anyway, Isaac prevailed. But anyway, God touched his thigh, and his thigh bone came out of socket. You might say, how can he do that? Well, God can do anything, can't he? So that means from that point on, Isaac was deformed. Couldn't walk anymore. And God even changed his name to Israel. let's go to Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, "Be not a terror unto me." And God said, "If you will return." Do you know what that means? God started terrorizing Jeremiah and actually drove him out into the world. Drove him away. Jeremiah came back, God did it again. Jeremiah came back, God did it again. It's almost like a game, ain't it? God threatened to kill Moses. The Apostle Paul. Apostle means Christian. He said, "Except these bonds, the Spirit unto life, killed all day long." None of that sounds good, does it? "Except these bonds" means anything but this walk. Killed all day long. If you kill a Christian walk, that means you bring that walk to nothing. That means you actually drive him into backsliding. But even though he might have wanted to backslide, he never did. the spirit unto life. That means would rather die than live. Now, if you go throughout the Bible, God did something to every one of his servants. See, he was known in the Bible as the God of Israel, but Israel was always being led into captivity. Anyway, my name is Bob Hickman, and you might ask, what is he doing to you? Well, you can click on the link in the comment section, and I tell some things there. Anyway, I'm going to cap the video right now. That means video's over.